So what is up guys, Badass Bullet here baby. So guys, this is gonna be a special video because we have got 1000 subscribers. So we are gonna review this Royal Enfield, not the classic 350, but let me show you what bike we're gonna review. So here the bike goes. This is Royal Enfield's cousin brother. So guys, this bike over here is a 1984 model. So let me tell you something about Mofa. It was released in the 1980s period when there was crisis for bikes, and then Royal Enfield was always, you know, in a different phase. They always wanted to think different, so they released this bike called Mofa. Which is 22cc, so if you can see the engine, it's so small, it's almost like my palm. Whereas we see the Royal Enfield classic engine, it's like 10 times bigger than this. So if you want to compare, then this engine would be the size of this electric starter, I mean the self starter. And if you see the air filter, this is the air filter. Let me open it and show it to you. So this is the air filter box, so this is the air filter. Whereas air filter of this is inside. So here I'll open and show it to you in the ending. But yeah, it's almost like, can you see this plastic part inside? The silver color, that is the air filter. It's not called the air filter, it's called the air cleaner, which works on a different basis. I'll explain it later. And guys, if you see the suspension in this, we have a very big suspension, whereas in this bike, we don't have suspension at all. All we have is a spring under the seat, so which is not that powerful enough for, you know, absorbing the vibrations. But yeah, you can use your hands and legs as suspensions. So even at the front, we don't have any suspension or anything. It's like a bicycle basically with the engine. The next thing would be the similarities between this bike and that bike. The only similarity which I observed is the exhaust. Same exhaust, even there. It has the same exhaust. And the spring under the seat. So guys, now let's talk about the bike and the features. So it has a headlight, which is again bulb operated. So it doesn't have any battery on the bike, it's all dynamo operated. And then we also have a tail light here. So that is all, no indicators, nothing else. So we have this, switching console, which I'm gonna show you. But this is not the stock one because that was broken, so we changed it. So this is the horn here, and these are the headlight switches at the down. And this small switch over here is the kill switch. Wow, that's so cool, right? Imagine a 1980 bike having kill switch. It's so cool. Like nowadays, Splendors and all those bikes don't have a kill switch, but a 22cc engine has a kill switch. That's something amazing. So guys, if you talk about the tires, 17-inch and 2.5D, getting these tires is very difficult. We won't get it at all. So if these tires are gone, then we would be sitting home and crying every day. I'll show you how to start the bike. And this is the petrol tank, guys. Inside the pipe, there is petrol. So we will have, this is a two-stroke engine, so we'll have to, you know, fill 2T oil plus petrol. And guys, coming to the brakes, they're amazing. Really, I'll show you how amazing they are. So both are drum brakes, which don't work at all. If they work, then it's your luck. So guys, to start the engine, as you can see, this is the choke. So we'll have to press it. So the choke is on. So another trippy feature of this choke is, as soon as you accelerate a little bit, it comes back to place. Can you see that? I'll show it to you again. So now the choke is on. Saw that? So now let's start the engine. So first press the choke. And then this doesn't have a kick rod. We'll have to pedal a few times and then it gets started. So guys, the bike is rolling now. You can see the engine is on. So let's hear the sound now. Two strokes, so there we can see a little bit smoke, but we can see that it's well maintained, so that's why there's not much smoke. We have high beam and low beam, that's cool. Okay, that's good. And then if you talk about the horn, so this is the horn, I'll turn off the headlight. And then this is the kill switch, so when I'm pressing it, it cuts off the power supply to the spark plug. So it turns off. Now let's ride this bike and see how it feels. So guys, this is the only bike which didn't need a FC or papers, insurance, nothing. So there's no number plate, there's nothing at all.
So I don't need the helmet also because I'm riding here only. So now let's go. Oh shit, we can't turn it on when the stand is off. So let's start the engine. Good. Brakes are also fine, but I saw some videos on YouTube where there are no brakes, so you have to stop with brakes. But yeah, this reaches a speed of 25 km/h, but if you pedal faster, you can reach 30 or 35. Now let's open it and see the parts of the engine. So all we have to do is loosen these two screws here. So guys, if you see, this is the coil for the ignition part, and this is the air cleaner. This is not called the air filter, in those days it is called the air cleaner. So this uses a centrifugal force technology where, you know, air is made to spin in circular direction. So that time the dust is thrown out, right? So that is what is happening inside this box. And this is the petrol knob, which is not stock, but yeah, this is for on reserve and all that. So this is the tank. So this is 1.45 liter tank. We'll have to fill 30 or 20 ml of 2T oil every time we fill fuel in this. So you can see this engine, the fins, it's all very small. This is the spark plug. Spark plug again is the standard size. And one more thing is, Enfield was ashamed to, you know, release this motorcycle. So that's why there's no branding anywhere. So wherever you see it, all we can find is Mofa, that's it, nothing else. But originally it's made by Enfield. And guys, this uses a centrifugal clutch, like the Kinetic Honda. And if you see the brakes here, it's all like cycle brakes. But these are okay, decent enough for stopping a bike which moves at 25 km/h. But yeah, if you don't maintain it, then you'll have to use your legs and everything else to stop the bike. So guys, if you talk about the cost of this bike, the owner had got it for 8k, but right now if you want to buy this, it would be around 20 to 25. But let me tell you one thing, getting this bike is impossible. If you get, then you're damn lucky. And then one more thing is, even after you get, getting spares for this bike is very, very difficult because it's a very old and the production has been stopped long back. So that is one of the problems which, you know, Mofa owners face. But still, this bike is not meant to be rode every day. It's just for collection sake. So that's it. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.